When I was getting out of veterinary college, I realized that a lot of the equipment that veterinarians work with, that nurses work with, that a lot of doctors who work in the field work with, are really poorly designed and not designed either for us or for our budgets. One of the first things I think that occurred to me when I was training as an intern in veterinary college was every time a professor would call us and say, hey, come and listen to this heartbeat. This is very interesting. You know, it's a heart condition or something else, and you need to know exactly what the details are. So we come over and we listen, but over the sound of other dogs barking and a cat's going crazy and all these things, you really can't hear anything. There's too much interference, too much noise. And even with our professor's stethoscope, which is considered one of the best premium stethoscopes, acoustic stethoscopes, it was very hard to actually hear it and make out the sounds. Things that are becoming a little bit more rare now, which is a good stethoscope technique. It's becoming rare in medicine as well as veterinary medicine. People are using their stethoscopes less, and it's not because of the fact that they're not useful. They're still very useful, and they're still the first way we make diagnosis. But the problem is that the technique has been lost over the years, and they're being replaced by things like echocardiography, which not everybody has, or ECGs, which again, not everybody has. And very importantly, different from these two things, is that the sound of a heart it's an acquired skill. Thal is a digital stethoscope. The concept of Thal is to be the kind of stethoscope that can take the sounds we hear and remove the major part of interference that really disturbs our concentration and disturbs our ability to hear the right sounds. We took a very sensitive microphone. We ran it through a circuit that repeatedly filters out and removes higher pitch sounds, particularly the ones above 1 kHz. And we also try and allow it to focus when necessary on specifically the heart sounds. So we're running two different kinds of sound filters. Also what we're allowing the device to do is to amplify the sounds and to actually make it clearer for us by doing noise cancellation. We provide the heart rate, so it's something that a doctor does not have to focus on counting. And counting is a mechanical task. We know we're error prone as human beings to making two separate counts at the same time. One is the time that's going by and the other is the heart rate that's going by. And so this is a very confusing sort of task for a doctor or any medical professional to do, and you're bound to make mistakes. So how about we just take the error-making thing out of it, give it to a circuit, let the circuit take care of it at a very high degree of accuracy. As you'll see, our stethoscope measures the beat down to the millisecond, and this is something that our brain is just not capable of doing. So even if the rate is very fast, like a human being in stress or a hummingbird for a veterinarian, these are really fast heartbeats that I cannot count in my head.